Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. It's Jacoby. So in today's video, I'm gonna teach you how to pass a volleyball without it hurting. I get so many comments about how people's arms are sore, that they say it hurts. I'm here to give you all my advice on how it can stop hurting and how you can get through that. But before we get into that, make sure you follow me on Instagram and TikTok at jacoby.sims. That is jacoby.sims. Subscribe if you haven't already. Almost like 70% of you aren't subscribed. Come on now and like this video and comment down below. Comment down below to help me out. Okay, let's get into the video. Okay, so first of all, you need to have correct passing technique. And if you want a how to pass video, I have already made one. I can leave it in the description. First of all, first and foremost, you need to have a strong platform. If you pass like this, it's gonna hurt. Okay, if you pass like this, it's gonna hurt. If you pass like this, it's gonna hurt. Let me show you the correct form for passing. So first of all, your shoulders are going to be rolled over, like you're shrugging your shoulders, so they don't want to be like this, because if you pass like that, you're going to get hit in the chest and that hurts. Shoulders over, you can either do a fist hand over, or you can do two hands fold in like that. I personally do this. So take your thumbs up, take your other hand, wrap it around, thumbs down, and lock out your platform and make it solid. If I was like this, it's going to hurt. If I'm even like this, my thumbs are up, it's gonna hurt. You're gonna break your fingers. Never ever interlock your fingers, because you will break your fingers. You need to have really, really good technique in order for it not to hurt. So let's go over that again. Straight arms, elbows are locked out, shoulders are shrugged. You almost want your shoulders touching your ears. Fold over your hand or do this, whichever, and lock out your elbows. And by the way, my elbows look weird because they're double jointed, but you get the idea. That's why they touch, is because they're double jointed. But if you're not, it's completely fine. You just want your elbows locked out and your platform, which is this part, your forearm right here, to be as firm as possible. Okay, so the next tip I have is to actually see the ball into your platform. So what I mean by that is, here's my platform, okay? And here's the ball, my finger. I'm watching it. I'm watching it into my platform. Because you want to make sure that the ball hits the correct spot. So a lot of people, I see beginners get like hurt because they hit the ball in the wrong area of their platform. And granted, that does hurt. But if you hit it in the right spot, it won't hurt as much. So if you contact the ball here, it's gonna hurt. Here, even worse, because that's like flesh more than bone. So it's gonna hurt. But if you contact it in the correct spot, which is not here, because that's also gonna hurt, that's your wrist bone, you need to put it right here on that bone and on your forearm. But that leads me into my next point. If you are a beginner, it will hurt in the beginning. Because for me, since I've been playing for 10 years plus, it doesn't hurt at all, just because I'm used to it. I built up a tolerance to it. But when I started, it did hurt a little bit because you're just not used to it. Just get adjusted to it and you kind of have to push through it. Next tip that also goes into that last tip is get repetition. I preach repetition on my channel so much. Reps, 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 reps. If I could say one thing to an aspiring volleyball player, get your reps in. It will make you so much better. First of all, your touch on the ball will be much better. And three, you will get used to the contact of the ball on your platform. So once again, like I just said, if it hurts in the beginning, it won't hurt the more you do it. So the more reps you get, the better overall in volleyball, but especially in this case. Next, if you're really a beginner, like I would say maybe 13 and younger. Hey guys, editing Jacoby here. I just want to clarify that beginners can be at any age, obviously, but ages 13 and down, they can actually play with volley lights, but any age above 13, you play with a regular ball. So the reason I said that 13-year-olds and younger should use volley lights is just because of that. They play with it actually, but if you're older, I just wouldn't recommend it for you, just because you would never play with it and it would just be detrimental to your touch on the ball because it is so much lighter. Okay, had to clarify that. All right. You can actually go out and buy a volley light. So a volley light is just a volleyball, but it's just a lot lighter than a regular volleyball, so it won't hurt as nearly as bad. It literally feels like a balloon to me. It won't hurt nearly as bad, so that way you can get your touches in, you can get your reps in at home, like I always say, but with a lighter ball, so it won't hurt as bad. And I will also leave one linked below. Next tip, this also goes into the technique, is just to avoid turning your arms out like this, because you're exposing all that sensitive flesh to the ball. You've gotta have them parallel, like sideways, where your bone is gonna hit the ball and not your flesh. See how that sounds? That hurts. This doesn't, because it's bone. Next is kind of like a cosmetic kind of deal, but you can also wear arm sleeves. You've probably seen in some of my volleyball vlogs, I do play with sleeves on. it's not really because the ball hurts. It's just really for like aesthetics. I like the look of it. One, and two, I dive a lot and I don't want to get a floor burn. So that's another reason why I wear arm sleeves. Sometimes I rarely do, to be honest, because I don't dive because I'm like a middle. So it's like pointless, but they look cute though. But I know a lot of my ZS libero friends wear arm sleeves because first of all, they dive a lot and they get a lot of balls hit at them that are hard. Sometimes we play against men's players and they just hit the crap out of the ball. So you have to kind of protect yourself. And also some arm sleeves have padding on it. So that's a good way to protect yourself. If you feel like you want sleeves, I would get them. Also link in description. Yeah. My last tip is to avoid overinflated balls. This means like those like really hard balls that are just super like pumped up and just full of air. Admittedly, those hurt. Like even to me, those are painful. I'm like, oh my gosh. I'm like, can we get like a ball that's a little flatter? So try to go for balls that aren't too flat, but aren't super overinflated. They're like the nice little happy medium. But that's it, you guys. I really hope you liked this video. If you did, let me know in the comments. I love you guys and I'll see you in the next one. Peace.